Hello and welcome to TechnoCouple channel. This video is the part 2 of Google Dialogflow CX integration with Twilio. You can watch part 1 using link given in the description. Now let's get into the actual integration. First, we need a Twilio and Google Cloud account. We also have a Dialogflow CX virtual agent ready for Twilio integration. So now log into your Twilio account. In another tab, log into Google Cloud account. We need to provide Twilio's production service account permission to access the Dialogflow agent. This is done in GCP's identity and access management screen. Navigate to IAM and admins page. Select IAM from the left navigation. Click plus grant access button. Under new principles, add virtual agent -ccai-prod at dialogflow-prod-env .iam.gserviceaccount.com as a member with the following roles: Dialogflow API reader and Dialogflow API client. Now click save. Now go to the Dialogflow CX console and select your project and agent. Click on the manage tab and click on integrations. Under the one-click telephony options, select Twilio. In the pop-up, give it a name. Select the environment and language for Dialogflow CX agent and click add. This will start the integration process and launch the Twilio console page. So we are being redirected to Twilio. In Twilio, give the name to this connector. Then you can provide the status callback URL, the URL to your endpoint where you want Twilio to send requests on call status, intents triggered, sentiment scores, etc. This field is optional, we are keeping it blank. Then in welcome intent friendly name, provide the name of the Dialogflow CX agent welcome intent you want to trigger when connecting the caller to the agent. If you do not have a custom welcome intent, you can use the system generated default welcome intent called welcome. Bot voice indicates the text to speech voice to use when synthesizing audio responses from the agent. Sentiment analysis, when set to on, Dialogflow will perform sentiment analysis on the end user input, and sentiment scores will be relayed on the status callbacks. Now click on next. Now review this information, modify as needed, and if you are ready, click on confirm configuration details. A pop-up has appeared, and to complete the integration, click on this blue button, agree and connect to Google. Now we are redirected to Dialogflow CX console, and in Twilio console, you can see your connector under the stream connectors option. So there you go, you can see this dental-clinic connector we just created. And now when we complete the integration, Twilio automatically creates a new studio flow with a connect virtual agent widget in it. Let's see if the flow is created. So let's open this dental-clinic flow. So as you can see, this widget is pre-configured based on the information provided earlier. All we need to do is to map this flow to the phone number. Now let's go back to Twilio's main console. Click on active numbers. And we have to select the purchase phone number. Under configure with, select the drop-down option webhook 2ml bin function studio flow proxy service.
Then under a call comes in, drop down, select studio flow, and in the adjacent drop down, select the flow we saw a few minutes back. All right, and now click save. Apart from studio flow, you can also use TVML bin or Twilio functions or webhook to connect with Dialogflow CX. If you would like to see a video on that, please leave a comment. Now let's verify our integration.
You have a trial account. You can remove this message at any time by upgrading to a full account. Press any key to execute your code.
Welcome to Dental Clinic. How can I help you today?
Are you open on Monday?
We are open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., Monday to Friday. On Saturday, we are open from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. We are closed on Sunday. Thank you for calling Dental Clinic. Goodbye.
So our integration is working just fine. We hope that this tutorial was helpful. That's all for now. We will see you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.